ESPN News, barely get all the attention, but Sammy now has his moment. It's his name among the all-time greats.
Chicken George, you ain't doodly. My cat Howard Finster. Oh, I put him on eBay sometimes and people get mad at me, but I didn't name the damn cat, my daughter did. Oh yeah. Yeah, I got
Phillips.
Well, I got paintings all over the place. And that's the Rulo's hat. Well, I guess Chicken George got one of those. But his head's too big for it, I'll tell you that right now. He went up there to that damn city and got a big head. What happened was, I think what started all this was him going up to Chicago for the Chicago City Art Show that me and him were in. I didn't go, but he went. He flew up there from Texas, and he had never been to a big city before. And I think what happened. I think the big city lights kind of threw him for a loop, and all the whining and dining and the art people up there and the interviews and all that stuff they did, I think it went to his head. I really did. And, Oh, no, I didn't go. That's a long story, really, but I didn't go. No. I've got animals here. I've got, you know, chickens and things in the back, and I didn't have anybody to feed them. So that was my main concern, was my animals. So this gallery calls us. And I want to put on a show. They're looking for the next great folk artist. They think that since Finster died a couple years ago, a lot of these poser artists are coming around. There's some festivals up there, Hootie Dooties or whatever they're called, Ha-Hoos, I don't know. Some of those people aren't artists from what's been said and what's known about them. But the leader of actually one of them is a damn Yankee marketeer that came down. He came down here and saw a folk fest and said, "Well, hell, I can market this." And now all these people think that this fool is some folk artist, and all that other junk they got's folk artist. It's cookie cutter. It's cookie cutter, and it's not just giving folk art a bad name. Cookie cutter. It's cookie cutter, and it's not the damn Yankee. Can you believe that? Hell, we're just artists. Well, it's not only, it's not just giving folk art a bad name.
given Southern Art a bad name. He's just making it look bad.
So anyways, these people, they want to find the next great folk artist. And I don't know, you know, it kind of sounds corny to me, but apparently all these other artists that they called didn't want to do it. And, well, from what I found out, was when they found out that me and Chicken George were in it, they didn't want to touch it. They're scared of us. Now Chicken George is spreading all this stuff about me, saying I paint on pizza boxes and all this stuff. Well, I paint on whatever I can find. Damn it, if I have a pizza box around and I ain't got nothing else to paint on, I'm going to paint on the pizza box. Well, he fooled around and I made a face on a pizza box and put it on eBay. And that just made him madder than hell. Supposedly whoever wins this gallery show is going to be the king of folk art. The king. The great folk art hero. How's your pizza? Well, yeah, this is good. Oh, Chicken George thinks he's hot stuff with his Texas jalapenos. Shoot, man, he can come down here. Well, he made me so mad that I'm just going to do pictures of him on pizza boxes for the show. His head's gotten so big from the Chicago show and what all those people told him up there that I'm just going to draw and paint his big giant head on pizza boxes. He ain't no match for me. He ain't no match for me. I can outwit him. I can outpaint him. I can outdraw him. I can outdo everything. I can out eBay him. I can pizza eat him. He ain't doodly. Okay, he ain't doodly. And he refried, he picked beans and put it in a frying pan and fried it until it's damn near cremated. Who the hell does that? Jalapenos are like drinking ice water. They ain't nothing. You see this piece of pizza, Chicken George? This piece of pizza is you. I'm gonna eat you up, boy.